Hey, buddy.
Hey, bud.
Oh, yeah.
You're streaming, aren't you?
Yeah, mate. Yeah.
I think I've stopped him talking to his best buddies.
Yeah, I thought I'd just join the chat anyway, see what's going on.
Yeah, that's not a lot, really.
Gonna get our first win today. Yeah. Need it.
I mean, my food's ready, so. We could speed up the game, James. Also, you've gone quite far from me there.
I mean, I was heading more to the circle, the ring, middle.
Yeah. Delivering her. Okay.
Watch her! You here for a bit of R&R like everyone else, eh? R&R? Not likely. We've things to be getting on with. Seriously? You went in Octagonia to let your hair down? Why else would anyone come here?
Oh, spike right over there.
Everyone's been miserable since it got all dark and that, right? Well, this is where people come to forget all that horrible stuff. To have a bit of fun. I met this girl on the road, as it happens. She said she was headed here too. Gosh, she was a looker.
Nothing of worth.
Dressed all funny she was.
Where's all the backpacks, too?
Martial artist types, you know.
Yeah.
I was hoping to see her here, if
I haven't
honest.
Had a single one. I just have a level one.
A beautiful
all I'm
martial artist, huh? You don't think it could be...
I know why I wanted to loot shit.
Bruv! There he is.
I'm going lower into this area.
Well, it was nice talking to you. Maybe we'll bump into each other in town again, eh? You took your time. Where have you been, you plonker? We got fun to be having. Come on.
Here, hold up.
The victory don't exist.
Octagonia. It has been a long time.
Yeah, well,
there's no harm in taking a quick look around town, eh?
No, I don't.
The lass he was talking about could be Jade.
Hello, backpacks. We got Prez.
Also, enemies don't.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna take on that team and then try and get a backpack.
He's such a great player.
Oh, it's a wonderful world of Dragon Quest, right?
Funner looking?
Yeah,
good man. What's with that ugly
yeah. Statue? So I keep leveling up off stream though.
Welcome to
it's making
well.
It so I can achieve a lot more. This battle's nice and quick. Oh, I got you.
A monster. Be on your guard.
Oh, come now. There's no need for all that.
Just to the right. Of us,
you're in the new Octagonia now. There's no fighting here anymore. Only fun.
I mean, like, thank you.
All
the
those
of where
tournaments
we are.
They
we
used to host. So
yeah.
The arena.
Didn't really think about it.
Now, thanks to Booga, best and most beautiful of the spectral fenton.
Wow, there's seriously nothing. There's a. Thing here that I can't attack.
Step inside.
Yeah.
Oh, chance your arm.
Jump. Yeah, that way.
It's just stairs.
I don't really have ranged weapons, so being here is not great.
Oh. Go that way. Go to the jump thing. Oh wait, we're in the ring.
A casino run by monsters.
Over there.
Eh? It all sounds a wee bit fishy to me.
We really should get to here, because that's
better go and
like,
take a look. Jade might be inside.
The best in the ring. Housewise.
any of your kind here. Well, don't worry. We'll look after you. If you'll just follow me. Yoo-hoo! I've got some humans for ya!
More lambs to the slaughter, eh?
Huh?
Can it really be? Princess?
Hendrik, what's a man as dull as you doing in a place as lively as this, I suppose even fine, upstanding knights of the realm need a cheap thrill every now and again, eh? Well, are you ready to play?
But you...
What's the matter, Henny Wenny? Cat got your tongue? Is the king's little lapdog scared of a bit of fun? I've been pining for a puppy, as it happens. Maybe I'll choose you, if you sit up and beg like a good boy.
Jade, listen to yourself, lassie. What's happened to you? Stop all this nonsense and come with us, will you? In case you've forgotten, Mordigan's still out there. We need you.
Oh, be quiet, you doddery old fool. You're ruining the mood.
Wow, Mordigan's still out there.
Well, he can stay out there for all I care. I'm Boogers now. He's the only one that matters to me. My heart. My soul, my body, they're all his. Why in the world would I want to join your band of do-gooders? I'm happy here. Happy. For the first time in my life.
You are a princess of Heliodor. You will behave like one. This den of iniquity is no place for a lady. You are coming with us.
Yeah.
Oh. I'm going nowhere, and you can keep your hands to yourself. What would you know about ladies, anyway? Tell you what, why don't I give you a crash course? My foot crashing into your face. I'm going to enjoy this.
Stay alert.
Lord Robert!
Shield!
Come on now, lassie. That's enough foolishness. Come along with us, will you?
Oh dear. Well, isn't this awkward? You appear to have nobbled my number one croupier. Let me introduce myself. I am Buga, Spectral Sentinel, the Raker of Hearts, Smasher of Heads.
We've heard of him, right? Oh, he's the one who turned Octagonia into such a silly spectacle. Honey, you have no taste.
Oh, Jade, my pretty little kitty cat. Look what the nasty people did to you. King Buga will punish them. You'll see.
Step away from the princess, fiend. She is coming with us.
You've come to steal away my pretty, have you? No, no, no. That just won't do. Not after I went to all the trouble of putting her under my spell. Do you think it was easy turning such a lovely girl into a horrible monster?
You can turn humans into monsters? Does that mean all the others are they?
Of course! Jade wasn't my first, you know. All my lovely girls used to be human, and the boys too. There's nothing like making a monster out of a smug human who thinks they've beaten the house. That soon wipes the smile off their faces, let me tell you.
Now listen here, you. Jade's coming with us. You'll be using her for no more of your nefarious nonsense.
Oh, dear. I'm afraid my casino has a zero-tolerance policy towards troublemakers. I would throw you out, but I'd rather crush you to a pulp.
Accept your fate.
Ha! Ha! I see you.
Leave it to me!
Hear me! Time to boogie, woogie, woogie!
Snap out of it!
Think you've heard stuff, do you?
Yes, sir.
Where am I?
Hendrik? All of you, what... what's going on?
Oh, it hurts. It's not fair. The house always wins, doesn't it? I am Booga, brightest and most beautiful of the spectral sentinels.
You. Booga. Yes. Now I remember. I remember everything, in fact. Have your wicked way with me, would you? With interest.
Princess, you're...
Looks like there's still a little of the old monster in me. Something tells me it's going to come in handy. I'm so sorry. You must have been so worried about me.
Ah, didn't give that a second thought, lassie. You're safe and sound now. That's the important thing.
Princess, my behavior was unforgiven. I do not ask for forgiveness. I ask only that you understand that all I do that the Lord of Shadows might be defeated.
What kind of way to say hello is that, Henny-Wenny? Less of the nightly nonsense. We'll have to spank you.
Oh,
I'm only joking. Thanks for always being there, Hendrik. I mean that. And as for you, something's changed since I last saw you. You seem tougher. Here, I think you'd better have this. I found it on my travels, and I've been trying to track you down to give it to you ever since. You already know how it works. Maybe one of those columns of light out at sea will open up some new horizons. Right, we've got more friends to find, and an evil overlord to beat. Don't you think we'd better get going?
Oh jeez, you're only level 39 then.
Victory!
Thank you.
not long now till we're through the strait.
What? What the? Who's that rattling around in my cargo bay? Would you be a sweetie and go check?
Gang, just in case. Huh? Erik? Honey, is it really you? You're alive, laddie. I knew you would be. Oh, this is the best news we've had in a while. You can say that again. It's wonderful to have you back, isn't it?
I'm sorry. I hadn't eaten anything for 3 days, and I saw you loading this boat with food, and I just couldn't help myself.
Are you okay, honey?
Something is not right. Is this really your former companion?
You said Erik, right? I'm pretty sure that's my name, but do I know you or something?
Don't you remember us, laddie? You're old partners in crime.
I'm sorry. I don't remember anything. I woke up, and everything was dark, and I had no idea who I was, or where. I remember my name, and I know there's something important I have to do. But apart from that... Look, I know I have no right to ask you this, but could I tag along with you guys for a while? If you know who I am, it might help me to remember something. I promise I'll pay you back for the food I took. I'll swab the decks, clean the dishes, anything.
No, no, there'll be no need for that, laddie. You stick with us. I'm sure your memory will be back soon enough.
What do you say, darling? Shall we forgive our little stowaway and welcome him back with open arms?
Thank you so much. I promise I won't get in your way. You won't regret this.
He's lost his memory and gained some manners.
I wish Veronica were here to see this. She'd die.
A
I'm sure that wasn't here before. Well, it looks like we won't be sailing that way anytime soon.
Well, that's not much help to us, eh? They can't get through to Arboria. They can't find out how to give old Mordigan what for. Wait, there's that pillar of light in the sea north of Sniflhiem, eh? Well, it's just a thought, but maybe that's worth a wee look. It's not too far off, after all.
To enter my realm. So we meet again, worm. You were lucky to slip the hook when last we met. You will not be so fortunate this time. In the name of my lord and master, I shall send your broken bodies to the bottom of the ocean.
Can he do the trick? I don't very well know what can.
Your hand.
The power of the luminary.
Should be able to land a blow or two. Right, you lot. Time to finally put a wee dent in our friend here.
You worms really believe you can defeat the mighty Aetherin? You will sink without trace.
Oh.
night. That lightning you summoned. Could you be the luminary? Lord Mordekon, hear me. The luminary. He has returned.
We showed you, you oversized sea slug. Think you're a match for the luminary? Think again, pal. Right, we'd better get a move on. We need to give Mordekon a good hiding before any more beasties like that one come a-growling. But first, we need to find out how we can hurt him. He still doesn't know you're alive, but it's only a matter of time. Best get a move on, eh?
What's going on? My heart's beating like crazy.
The fall of Yggdrasil has changed everything. It's more than likely Sniflhiem didn't escape unscathed. Which is why I think we'd better check in on Queen Frisabel before we head off to Arboria. That all right with you? Right. We're away to the castle to see the Queen. While we're at it, why don't you lot take a look around town and make sure everything's okay? What's the matter, Erik? You look like you've seen a ghost, lad.
It's nothing. I'm fine. You want us to take a look around town, right? I'm all over it.
And second thoughts, you're coming with us. You're in no fit state to be wandering around on your own.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to be a burden.
Come on now, laddie. This isn't like you. Chin up, eh? A stroll to the castle will do you the power of good. Cheer up, Your Majesty. It might never happen. What's got you looking so glum?
Lord Rab! And your friends, too. I'm so happy to see you safe and well.
Aye, the feeling's very much mutual. A lot's happened since last we met.
Indeed. Yggdrasil has fallen. The world has been covered in darkness. Gold fever ravages my kingdom, But we survived. Some were not so lucky.
What's that now? Gold fever? Is there something going on around these parts we should know about?
There is. It all began a few weeks ago, you see. A strange disease started to spread across Sniflhiem. It affects people, animals, even plants. Anyone or anything that catches it turns entirely to gold.
To gold?
We don't know what causes it or how to cure it. So every one of my poor subjects lives in fear of being struck down next. I tried to send for help, but every route out of the kingdom is blocked by great golden obstacles. We are completely cut off. My dear friend Kristalinda was studying the illness to try to find a cure, but in their panic, my people suspected her of spreading it instead. For her own safety, I was forced to lock her away in the dungeons. I have tried to tell my subjects she is innocent, but they simply will not listen. They are blinded by fear. This awful disease has turned my kingdom upside down.
There, there, Your Majesty. Then he looks a crestfallen. We'll get to the bottom of this for you.
Oh, thank you. You are always so very kind to me. I will let everybody in the city know that you are here to help, and that they must help you in turn. Take care, dear friends.
Gold. My gold.
There you are. Is everything all right?
Not exactly. You see,
the queen seemed awful sad, and she told us about this.
Hello there, madam. Do you have a minute to talk to us? We'd like to ask you a few questions.
Do I have a minute, he asks. How can I know when every second might be my last? You do well to leave this place before you turn to gold too. Wait, I know you. You're that boy, Erik.
You know me?
Oh, don't be silly. Everyone in Sniflhiem knows you. You're the... No! This can't be happening!
What's the matter, dear? Are you okay?
It's got me.
I take it this is a case of gold fever. It's horrible.
Erik, honey, are you okay? Tell me where it hurts.
Erik? Ah. I heard a commotion and came running. I never thought that I would find you here.
Do you know our friend, Father? He's an old pal of ours, but we lost him after the fall. I fear he's taken a blow to the head somewhere along the way. He doesn't remember a thing about his life before then.
Oh, my poor child. Perhaps I can help to jog your friend's memory. Come to the church by the city gates, and I will tell you what I know of his past. There you are. I am glad to see you safe and well, Erik. It has been 5 long years since last we met.
I was here 5 years ago? Did I used to live here or something?
Not quite. The Viking raiders who once roamed the northern seas would often stop here to buy supplies. Or to drink away their ill-gotten gains at the inn. And when they came, Erik, you came with them.
I'm a Viking?
So that is why the men I sent to scour Heliodor for details of your origin would always return empty-handed. You were born here, a Viking.
Not born one. Erik and his younger sister were orphans. The Vikings found them, took them in, and raised them as their own. Whether that was for good or bad, I really couldn't say. By all accounts, they treated the poor children like slaves. Then, one day, we heard rumors that Erik's sister had passed away. And though the Vikings returned, Erik never did.
Stop.
It has always saddened me that I was not able to help those poor children more. Perhaps if I can help you to recover Erik's memories, it might...
I said stop! I need to be alone for a while.
Forgive me. It was tactless of me to reveal so much so soon. Please, go to your friend. I will join you when he has had a chance to settle down.
I'm sorry I ran off like that. It's just... Huh. Is that...
That ship, if the townspeople's shouts are anything to go by, it is not a welcome sight.
I will take care of Erik. Please, you must hurry to the harbor.
Empty your pockets, sniveling Sniflheimers. It's time to pay tribute to the great and glorious Kildigger. All your gold belongs to us. Come on, you clattering curs, let's get to work. Grab the golden statues and load them into the longboat. Metal-headed morons! Get the statue back to the ship! You don't want to keep Kildigger waiting!
The monsters are making away with the people who were turned to gold. Could the fever be their doing?
What are you looking at? Mess with us, and you'll have to answer to the great and glorious Kildigger, shining star of the Spectral Sentinels!
Cease your boastful blustering, fiend! You dare disturb the peace of this fair nation? Then it is you who shall answer to us!
You think you can stop us, feeble fleshbags? You're not even worth stealing! The boss only likes two kinds of humans, gold ones and dead ones. Let's bury 'em, boys!
Guys!
Their companions are fleeing! After them! Over there.
Erik! They've got Erik! Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh! How? Why?
Never mind why. They must be stopped. Quickly.
We were too slow. Oh, Erik.
We are getting that boy back, and we are doing it right now. Where's that priest? He'll know where they've taken him.
I am sorry. The creatures found us, and I was powerless to stop them taking Erik away.
Please, do not be so hard on yourself, Father. It is a miracle that even you escaped with your life. When we heard that you were outside the gates when the monsters attacked, we feared the worst.
Curse those sparkling scoundrels! They have run away with every man, woman, and child struck down by the fever. They just picked them up and carried them off like so much plunder. Do they mean to sell our friends, our families?
But then why would they take Erik? He had no valuables in his possession, and he was not afflicted by the fever. And yet, they headed straight for him. It is almost as if they knew exactly who he was. Wait a moment. The way they spoke, the ship they sailed in, could they be?
You know, I had the very same thought.
Yes, I thought maybe those things had usurped the villains, but it seems they are them. But how?
Those gold hungry horrors. They may look different, but we know them. We know them very well indeed. The way they moved, acted, talked. The fact that they knew who Erik was. There is no mistaking it. They were Vikings. Used to have a hideout near here, in a little cave just around the headland. I think that is where they have taken your friend.
And be merry, boys. We got a good haul today. The guild diggers sure to reward us.
Huzzah! Huzzah!
We did especially well to bag this one. The boss has been after him for a long time. Hey, what the heck heck are you doing here? Wait, I know you. You're that rotten luminary.
You're dead right, Chief. He looks just like the picture on the wanted poster. He's the luminary, all right. I'll run up to the Gilded Hall and let the boss know he's here.
Seems you're quite the celebrity, darling. I can't say I'm not jealous.
This is no time for jokes, Silvando. We're here to rescue Erik, remember?
You think you're going to plunder our plunder? Just try it. We'll beat you blacker and bluer than the Lord of Shadows did.
Chief, just imagine the reward you'd get if you took in the Luminary's head on a platter. One of those empty spectral sentinel seats could be yours.
Hey, that's not a bad idea. Come on then, boys. Let's swipe ourselves a skull that's worth its weight in gold.
Sorry to leave you stewing in there, laddie. They didn't hurt you, did they?
Well, you're safe now. Let's head back to Sniflhiem. The priest's worried sick about you.
Aye.
Something is still not right. Erik, what did those fiends do to you?
I was here, and they were... Yeah. So, she must be... I've... gotta go.
What was all that about, hmm? Come on, darling. We'd better get after him.
What's the matter, Runt? Tired? You soon will be. You got a problem, boy? We've been looking after your brats for 10 long years, ever since we found you freezing in that snowfield. You owe us your lives, so how about you start showing us some respect?
Yes, Chief. Sorry, Chief.
Ugh.
that?
In trouble again? You know what your problem is, dear brother? You need to learn to grovel more convincingly.
Huh? Hey, Mia.
I know how you feel, though. I hate their big fat guts as much as you do.
Shh.
Oh, don't be such a scaredy cat. Just hurry up and finish your work so we can go home. Tell you what, since I'm such a good sister, I'll stick around and cheer you on. Woo! 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 Woo!
The only reason the chief's working me so hard today is because you got caught with your hand in his coin purse. You could at least help.
Make me. Me and my big mouth.
Yeah. Thanks for the help, Mia.
Oh, stop moaning, will you? If you keep being horrible to me, I won't share any of my riches with you when I'm a millionaire.
Ugh, not that again. Still, I guess it's good to have a dream. One of these days, we're gonna get our hands on a whole pile of treasure, and then we can wave this lousy place goodbye.
Forget a pile. I'm not gonna stop till I've got myself a mountain.
But first things first, we gotta find something to eat. Huh. If we had wings, we could fly away from here. We could go wherever we wanted.
What are you, 5? You won't be flying anywhere on an empty stomach. Know what I think when I look at that thing? Dinner. Day? Huh? What the heck is this?
Just something I picked up on today's raid. No birthday's complete without a present, right? Happy birthday, sis.
Huh? Is this the best you can do? A rusty old necklace? Honestly, Erik, you need to try harder. What I really wanted was the red orb of Heliodor. Word is, it's a ruby the size of my head.
Huh. Word is, that necklace has special powers. They say that whoever wears it will find gold at their fingertips wherever they go. It's probably just talk, but it seemed about right for a little money grubber like you. I guess you'll just have to put it on and find out if... Where did you get that from?
I don't know. It was the copper coin a minute ago. But as soon as I touched it, it...
You've been at it again, huh?
What's the matter, Erik? Jealous of my treasures? Tell you what, if you ask me really, really nicely, I'll let you have one. Let me see now. Perfect!
Huh? Wait, you didn't, did you? Mia, this isn't right.
Yeah, I suppose it is a little small. I forget how greedy you are.
Seriously, Mia, it's not funny. This has to stop.
Hey, there's no need to shout. And anyway, you're the one that gave me this thing. Ugh. Okay, I get it. I guess I have been getting a little carried away. Just stop looking at me like that, will you?
I'm sorry I lost my cool, okay? It's just...
No, it's fine. I'll stop turning stuff into gold. For now. Huh? Why won't it...
What's wrong?
The necklace. It won't come off.
Come on, Mia. Stop fooling around.
I'm serious. I can't get it off. What's happening now? I didn't do anything, I swear.
Don't move. Damn it! What the hell's going on?
Ah!
It was all my fault. After what happened, I ran away. I wanted to leave this place, to leave my past behind. I asked around about the necklace on my travels and finally found out what it was. I'd given my sister a cursed relic. I wanted to forget who I was and what I'd done. So I threw myself into any adventure that came along, and before I knew it, I was living as a thief. That's when I met him. The guy who called himself the Seer. He told me to go after the orb, that if I did, I'd meet the Luminary somewhere deep underground, and that if I helped him, I'd finally be forgiven. At first, I didn't believe a word of it. Kind of circles I was moving in, you learn pretty quickly not to trust anyone but yourself. But sure enough, I went after the orb, I wound up underground, and I met you.
Your memory, laddie. It's back.
It is. Thanks to you guys. Guess I've been kind of a pain these last few days, huh? I'll make it up to you, I promise. Who knows if I'll ever find the forgiveness the Seer promised me. But everything else he said came true. Maybe that will too. You saw it, right? The statue my sister turned into was right here. If this Gildigger guy is collecting all the gold he can get his hands on, maybe he took her too. I heard those golden goons saying he's holed up in a castle north of here. I'm gonna get Mia back if it's the last thing I do.
Then it looks like we're all headed the same way. After all, we've got some Sniflheimers to rescue, right?
Thanks again, you guys. It's good to be back.
Thank you.
Hold on tight now!
Excellent.
Could it be?
At all.
one for the great Sylvanda grows even greater.
Mia?
Call me that again and you'll regret it. I haven't been Mia for a long time. The name's Gildiga.
Wait, you're...
Yes, well done. I'm the big baddie. It was all me. Gold fever, stealing all the statues. Me, me, me. What's the matter, dear brother? Aren't you happy to see your little sister doing so well for herself? Anyway, what are you doing out of your cage? I wasn't planning on having my men bring you here till later.
You have every right to hate me, Mia. I hate myself for what I did to you. But the Vikings? The fever? Why would you do all this?
Oh, questions, questions. Always with the questions. Fine. If you're so desperate to know, then I'll tell you. It all began when the World Tree fell from the sky, and the Lord of Shadows went to visit a certain lucky girl.
By your guardians, by your brother, one heart overflows with greed, with rage, with despair. You will make a splendid addition to my world of darkness. I am Mordigan, Lord of Shadows, ruler of all Erdrea. Come, child, drink of my power and be reborn.
Monster do to you?
Monster? He's not the one who left his sister to rot all alone in a cave. Thanks to that monster, I'm here today. Thanks to him, I have all the gold, all the power I ever wanted, and more. And for my next trick, I'm going to turn everyone in the world into golden soldiers, just like those stupid Vikings, and work them all to the bone.
Ah, so you really did turn the chief and his men into your slaves. What's happened to you?
You really think you deserve to know? After all you've done, I'll show you what you deserve.
I've thought about you every day for the last 5 years. The thought of saving you was the only thing that kept me going. It's all my fault. All of this. Everything that's happened to you. Which means I have to finish this. I have to take you down.
Now you decide to play the hero? You're too late. You couldn't save me, and you can't save yourself. Or your pathetic little friends. Why can't you all just leave me alone? I don't need a brother, or a hero, or anyone. You're worthless to me, but you'll be worth your weight in gold.
Let's go!
Surrender your soul!
Thank you.
luminary.
Another day, another victory.
Diligence is its own reward.
There's life in the old dog yet.
Things lost control of our power. If we can't stop her, gold fever's gonna spread like wildfire.
I can't let that happen. This is all my fault. I'm sorry, Mia. I have to end this. I can't do it. She's my kid sister. I have to try and save her.
Why can't we go back to how things used to be? When we'd fight and laugh and fight some more? When all we had was each other? We didn't need money. We didn't need anything. I don't care how poor and cold and hungry we were. I want it back. I don't need this. I don't need gold! Nice work, Erik. Just lost us a fortune.
Your sister was a vessel for a power beyond human understanding. It has taken a terrible toll. We must let her rest. But do not fear, my child. Her life is not in danger. In time, she will recover.
I owe you. Mia owes you. Here, you should have this. The seer told me that if I helped the Luminary, I'd find forgiveness. Guess he knew what he was talking about, huh? We'd better make a move. Mia's safe here for now, which is good, because I've got things to be getting on with. Like helping you take Mordigan down. Let's hit the road, partner.